Welcome back everyone to It's Not Easy Being Green Screen. Here we are with the fantastic 128K remake of R-Type for the Amstrad CPC in glorious colours. Yes, colours I say, because the original of course didn't have so many colours to its credit because it was a Spectrum port. Never mind. Easter Egg in 2012 resolved this situation with this remake, and a fantastic remake it is. We just skipped the lovely intro there, because we'll see the intro later in green. I think we've seen it. If you want to see it in colour, you can skip to my NRG video of this version of R-Type on the Amstrad and have a look at it there. We're just going to play up to, I don't know, third away through the first level and then switch to green. We lose all this awfully lovely colour. Bang, there goes the Baidu. It's quick, it's fast, it's responsive, it's bloody hard, it's colourful, it's got the music, it's got the sound effects, maybe not always at the same time, but hey, you can't have everything. It's got much improved scrolling, not perfect scrolling, granted, but much improved scrolling. It is a lovely, lovely version of the game, probably the best version could have been made for the Amstrad given its capabilities. Wonderful stuff. Let's get rid of this guy. But we all know about the version. Most people who in the Amstrad sphere and general gaming sphere actually know about this version. Do all agree it's rather wonderful, if I can get my words out. So it's going to be interesting to see what's in green, because obviously some games in the past were designed to play in green as well as colour, but this kind of wasn't. I would hazard a guess it was never designed to play in green at all. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens, especially when the backgrounds sort of fade and change colour and things like that. Because you've got things like that going on, so that's going to be interesting, really. So, let's pause the game and switch to green. Green Baidu, please, now. Right. Whoa, these Baidus have gone a bit bright. Of course, the background's starting to fade in now, so yes. Whoa. Of course, it seems to have more of a fade effect in colour. It doesn't sort of jump out at you so obviously like that, like it does in green. But that weren't too bad. And yeah, the R9 is still pretty well defined against even the colour background. The rocket launcher guy, he's a bit blurry, isn't he? He's merging into the background a tad. But most of the enemies are pretty well spotted still. Lasers certainly are, that was good. You can just see the glow of the beam as well coming out from the front of the force there. Yeah, it's still very, very, very playable indeed. I couldn't quite see the target for the snake there, but I knew where it was from memory, but if you didn't know where it was from memory, it was difficult to see the target, the main eye target for the snake. So if we go back into black, we'll see with the space black background, we'll see what the comparison's like with the ship then, because now because we're inside this sort of like, inside the stage of the first level, we've got the background. We can see the turrets at the top there quite clear. Yeah, that's not bad. The bullets are even more clear than they would normally be, because obviously they're orange and red. That's the pit down there. Let's grab that. Yeah, that's not bad. Again, of course, the shading on the pit, the shading on the R9, the shading on the force is sort of like merging in with the background there, because obviously the shades of green are limited. Oh, the air-to-air laser loses its... It loses its prowess in green, doesn't it? With the pink and the blue rings squishing through the air. Yes, two shades of green rings don't really look impressive. But I tell you what, it just shows, it goes to show that the detail used in Mode Zero, yeah, the detail is actually really, really well done. Even when you take away the colour, you can actually see the detail. Ah, now that's better. So with the black background, everything is a lot more clearer. Yes, indeed. Let's look at Dog Keratops in green. Normally in a lovely shade of orange, and now he's in green. Again, look at the lovely detail. You can see that it's drawn so well when you just use a monochrome colour. Yep, looks pretty terrifying. Let's we'll destroy him, and then I think we'll call it a day. Leave the rest of you, rest of our type to your imagination. There we go. Dog Keratops, it's dead. With lots of lovely green explosions. Thank you for watching. Not easy being green screen in our type. And I'll leave you with the intro sequence. In green, of course.